Okay, so Mark's actually gonna take a little bit longer because I don't know why. There's always a delay with OBS. But, hey guys, SuperVent47 here, back in Clandestine with my best friend Aaron.
Hey guys!
So first thing to make you guys aware of, the bank job kind of, I don't know, the graphic card overheated or something like that, which I've never had happen before. I've never had this happen before.
Was it the graphic card or the game?
So I got an alert saying the graphics card crashed and my whole screen went black. Like, it died. I could still hear the audio though. I could still hear you. Cause I guess the audio wasn't being passed through my
card?
Yeah, my card. But yeah, it just, my graphics card crashed. It's never done that except for this game. Like, there, I can, the only two times where my graphics card has crashed like that is when I tried to play Hearthstone while rendering. So that crashed because the rendering takes up like 90% of the graphics card CPU.
Right.
And the other time being playing this game while recording it on OBS.
All right.
That's sneak. Wait, hang on. Oh, left button is sprint. Okay, so we'll have to replay the bank mission because when my graphics card crashed, the file was corrupted. I was able to start recording again immediately afterwards, but we'll just play through the bank mission and then I'll splice in what happens afterwards so we can just jump to the next mission for us.
Mm-hmm.
So
on the harder difficulty, right?
Oh yeah, we're going to be playing all missions and stuff like that on harder difficulty.
Because all right, challenges.
Yeah. Okay, so
I'm waiting for you at the analysis office.
Oh, right.
I think this is the analysis office.
Is that Sarah's office downstairs?
The one with the big map.
Yeah. Okay, I'm on my way.
The new guy? Yeah, this guy.
Oh, that guy.
Oh, I'm floating.
Holy Mother of Jesus!
Interesting.
Yep, you have just. Wait, nope. Nope. You're out, yep.
I don't want to know where his face is.
Dude, you're like that. The uncle in Mary Poppins who, like. You've seen that. Have you seen that section?
Where he floats.
He just starts laughing. You have to cry, Aaron! Feel sad! Sad feelings.
I don't usually feel sad. It won't work.
Well, that's it. We have to go. We have to go talk to
this good. Lady. I'm up on the bench now. On the table.
Dude, when you see the scene of what happened to Baxter in the episode that had Melissa and I just cracking up, mm-hmm. Holy crap, dude. you'll be amazed.
I need to watch that when it goes up. I'm telling you. I saw nothing on my end.
There was a short circuit, and the UPS couldn't handle the load. I don't know how long it's been running on the backup. Thank you. Everything seems to be working again. Will this last?
Yeah, sure, whatever. Tomorrow,
but get a proper electrician out here. Somebody who has spare parts.
I will. Again, thank you so much for the help, Katya.
Stop mind melding, people. Use your words.
Of course. I'll let you get back to work.
Use your words. I don't know if they'll do the cutscene here or not, but after the bank job, you're actually given Katya here gives Martin a secondary mission to go to help bug three various spots in this facility, mm-hmm. because honestly we don't trust them, and we found out some really incriminating information. Do you remember what said information was, Aaron?
Oh, we are not sanctioned.
Oh shit!
You forgot that, huh?
Oh shit! I thought it was like I don't know, Josiah got a freaky thing for animals. Or, no, wait, that was the guy in the bank.
Yeah, that was the job, yes.
Okay, never mind. Wow! I'm getting my wires crossed. Imagine me busting into Josiah's office saying, I know you got a thing for animals, dude. I'm not gonna judge you, but okay, I just wanna let you know that. Wow, whew, you saved me some embarrassment there, man.
Mm-hmm, just a little bit.
So, yeah, we find out that this whole area, which is, we're supposed to be an FSB-CIA cooperative unit. We're not sanctioned at all. We're completely off the books, illegal.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently it's treason.
It is treason.
Mission selection! Are we going... No, we're going to London. And we're going to do this on insane difficulty!
We'll see how this goes.
Okay. Ghost, Pacifist, and Anonymous. Alright, here we go. Let's get suited up. Outfit unlock, covert ops. Ooh, do I get an outfit? Oh man, I do get an outfit! Stealth, low, armor, high, equipment slots, full 6 of 6. I can just walk in there, grenades! Grenades! Everywhere.
You get a grenade, and you get a grenade!
Everyone gets grenades! It's gonna be great. Oh, don't we have... Oh, a Nerf gas grenade, nah. Alright, I'm gonna want 2 pagers. And I'm gonna want a Banshee? No. Remote modem. Alright, let's do this. Yes, no firearms. Would we like to watch the briefing again?
You know, that's up to you.
I would say yeah, since we didn't catch it on the recording, so we're doing this for you guys. Alright. Mystery Space Theater 3000, go! 9 days after Copenhagen.
Alright, everyone. Before we begin the briefing, I'd just like to thank you all
for your work. Where's the popcorn?
It's been a rough start. But it feels like we've all begun to set aside our differences and get into the swing of things. Keep up the good work. Now, I'll let Sarah explain what the analysis department has discovered since Copenhagen. And then I'll get into the details of this next operation.
He's into feet.
Well, thanks to the efforts of our field team, we've had full access to the data compiled by Absalom in the months leading up to his death. Absalom was charting the monetary flow from the pan-European and the South American drug trade. He managed to get quite close to identifying a single common destination for this money. But of course, he was not an Alanist. We managed to finish what he started. We've traced the accounts to a London-based financial company called Catalyst Investment Group.
How much money are we talking about?
On the order of hundreds of millions of dollars.
What's it all for?
It's clearly some sort of money laundering scheme. Catalyst is a black hole into which a staggering amount of capital is disappearing. It must be coming out somewhere else. But we can't see past the event horizon, to maintain the metaphor.
I see where this is going.
Yes. Of course, we need to get inside Catalyst. We need to get a hold of their files, both physical and digital, so we can trace the movement of the drug money through the organization and identify the recipients.
Hold the phone. How does this relate to our mission?
This money laundering scheme is the best lead we've got. The betrayal of Absalom fits the pattern of our leaks. For now, we're assuming that whoever was responsible for our leaks also sold out Absalom and Mr. Mansour. At the same time, it's clear that this scheme is at the heart of Absalom's death. Absalom and Mansour were investigating different parts of the same criminal operation, and they were both getting very close indeed. We conclude that they were sold out in order to impede the investigation.
How can we know that?
The cash flow stopped shortly after Absalom died. The operation is probably being restructured, while the CIA is scrambling to establish new NOC agents. It's not conclusive evidence, but it's enough to act on.
Hmm.
Thank you, Sarah. I've chosen.
Especially because they're not sanctioned.
Mm-hmm.
while Mr. Mansour will track down Absalon's German contact and connect with his network in Central Europe.
We're going to London?
It's an accounting office. We'll be fine.
Our pretext should get you through the front door without any trouble. You have two pairs of objectives.
So who knows that we're not sanctioned?
That the chief internal auditor should have the
I would assume just those two.
Search his office. Me too.
Then search the physical archive in the basement. Two, the server room is on the third floor. But first, you'll need to secure a decryption key from the IT office.
I can get into the IT computers remotely. We don't need to get CAD in there.
What's the pretext?
You're on the cleaning crew. That should get you past the lobby and let you roam the hallways. If you need to search the offices, you'll still have to keep a low profile. The main problem is getting past the archive guard. The only way into the archive is past a permanently staffed security desk. You may have to get your hands dirty at that point. Unless Mr. Szymborski can find a pressure point for whoever's on duty when you arrive.
How's the security?
Handled by a contractor called Safeguard, one of the few private firms licensed to carry lethal weaponry in the UK. They're one step above mall cops, but don't underestimate them.
No time to waste.
You'll leave tomorrow morning. Make sure you're ready for any eventuality. Good luck.
All right, we know what to do. We know this mission pretty much inside and out.
Yep, now we're on hard difficulty. We'll see how the differences are.
Hardest.
Hardest difficulty.
Hardest. The Leon difficulty. Still don't know who that references.
Not sure.
Have you seen that 1994 film, Leon the Professional? I think I showed it to you once.
I remember looking at it, but that's about it.
I think that might be it.
In the lobby. Security looks light. Are you ready?
I'm hooked into the network.
Oh, jeez. It's a little bit bigger here.
I will. Alright, well, you be careful. I'll be careful.
Uh-huh. We'll you're blue. Be good. Yeah, you're blue. When you get to the second floor, let me know.
Okay.
Cleaning supplies are on the second floor. Remember, you're not allowed.
Hey, you're different from the previous guy.
Thank you.
Have a nice evening.
The previous guy didn't have the cut.
Oh, you didn't? Oh, this was taking a lot longer. Six.
Can I take intel? You have intel? Can I take that? Yes, I can! Oh man, I just lifted some intel off of this guy.
Nice.
Alright, I'm making my way into...
Downtown?
That joke is dead. That joke is deader than a zombie in The Walking Dead. Alright.
That's pretty dead.
That's super dead.
Alright, so you're walking upstairs.
Aaron, what shows were out in 1996? Just curious. Like, what shows do you remember?
That I actually watched?
Yeah. I was 6 years old in 96, so I watched a lot of TV.
What, the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers?
Yeah.
My sister watched that. What else was 90? What, Space Above and Beyond? I think that was on.
I watched Hercules: The Legendary Journeys.
I think you still watch that, don't you?
I still watch it.
Oh, it's that's a bad space. That's a bad space.
Understood.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's the IT department. Never mind.
You can go there, just let me know.
Okay. Well, there's a guy right behind me anyway.
I mean, there's only two cameras. You could probably go in there if you wanted to.
Yeah, but the security guard, and there's also a laser grid.
There's two laser grids, I think.
Oh, boo. Alright, we're going up to the dude.
Okay, I don't know who he is.
Alright, Whisper. You're heading towards the archive. We won't know what to look for until you find the auditor's records from his office.
Yep, let me know who he is.
He looks different. Oh yeah, he looks different.
Okay, then I have no clue.
I'm sorry, but the cleaning crew is not allowed down here.
Are you John Smith?
Smith? No, my name is Dylan Gilbert.
Nope, Dylan Gilbert.
Okay, so it's probably the same thing.
We even have a John Smith here. What is this about?
This is the archive room, yes?
Let me know if it's still adultery.
Who are you?
I was told to find the archive room and speak to the guard. I thought the name was different.
If not, I'm gonna gamble on adultery.
I'm on this post tonight. Now, what is this about?
Yeah, it's still adultery.
Okay.
On this post?
Yes, I'm always on this post. Every Monday, the archive room is mine.
And you weren't told I was coming?
I was led to believe that you had been informed.
Nobody tells me anything, apparently. Maybe if you would tell me...
Adultery!
We can find out if I can let you into the archive or not.
Do you worry that your wife might learn about your affair?
What? How? What do you want?
All I want is to have a quick look at some files. Nothing so dangerous.
So how much harder was it?
Yes.
All right. A little bit.
A little bit tough?
Yeah, not much.
Really? This is the max difficulty.
Well, this is a fairly straightforward mission until we get to the second or the third floor.
Oh, yeah. Alright, I'm going into the thing.
Into the thing. One guard, two cameras.
One guard. Intel. How do I know what intel to take?
Your objective is not in that room right now.
What?
I'm looking at the objective.
Find the chief auditor's records. It should be in this place.
Nope. It's showing me it's in the... I guess the southeast.
What the crap?
It was here before.
It was supposed to be in here.
Right. Now it's harder because it's down here in a non-sanctioned room.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, alright, that's one way to adjust the difficulty, I guess. Shit, actually kind of makes sense. It kind of makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it. Alright. Where am I?
Go south. Turn to your right. Yep, go down. Nope.
Am I right? Okay.
There you go, straight down. Now to your left, down the hallway, straight in front of you. There's a camera. Let me know when you're ready.
Yeah, I'm ready. Got it?
Yep, let me see if the guard's clear, go. Nice. Yeah, shut the door.
Come on. There we go.
Again, yeah, it's right there. Nope, go to your right.
Go to my right?
Right there.
Oh, yeah, here it is, the ledger. Oh, that's right, we have to go to the ledger first. Alright, how's the guard?
Guard is coming back down towards you.
Alright, I'll hold off here. Some memorandum. People who don't know, it's just a memorandum saying, oh, this person caused this much bull crap and they're lying and blah 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 blah.
He's right outside the door.
Of course he is.
And he... Oh, I thought he was gonna come in for a second. Okay, he turned away.
Okay, let me know when he's... Okay, cool.
Yep, he's turning up. Yep, you're good.
You know what I don't understand?
Mm.
Cleaning people are only allowed in the hallways, right?
Mm-hmm.
So who cleans the offices?
Nobody.
Nobody?
They bring the trash cans outside.
Oh, but what if someone makes a mess in the office?
They have to clean it up themselves.
Oh, well... Shit. Mm-hmm. Okay, then.
I have the same problem in my work.
Ah. See, yeah, we don't have that problem. The cleaning people just come right in and do
mm-hmm.
things.
Yeah, the room I work in for the cell culture stuff is locked down. Alright, right there in front of you.
Right here?
Little further.
Little further?
Now go straight south.
Straight...
That's north.
Shut up.
There you go.
It was on the other side.
We are heading to the server room.
Understood, Condor.
Alright, up to the server room.
I'm just walking.
Actually, on sunshine?
I'm walking on sunshine.
That reminds me of a 90s movie.
Alright, which one?
Look Who's Talking.
Who's in that one?
Was it Christy Alley and John Travolta?
Wow, Christy Alley?
Mm-hmm.
That's a name I haven't heard in a long time.
Pretty sure those are the two.
Oh my goodness. Alright,
upstairs.
Movies from the 90s that I have watched.
That you enjoy.
That I enjoyed. Ooh. The first movie I remember watching and enjoying was actually not from the 90s.
Okay, let's see.
But I watched it during the 90s.
There's a camera.
Let me know when.
Go ahead.
Isn't there a guy here?
Yeah, he's walking the perimeter.
Okay. Alright, I'll just catch him when he comes this way. Let me just switch cover. There we go. So, first movie I remember watching in the 90s that I enjoyed, it wasn't actually from the 90s, it was the very first Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle movie.
Mm.
It was the hardcore, more mature version before they went off the... before they went off their rockers with, like, bringing on Vanilla Ice and...
Yeah, Bebop and Rocksteady.
Yeah.
Using everything but their weapons for battle.
Because it's supposed to be a kid's movie.
Uh-huh.
Whereas in the first movie, it was just, like, weapons everywhere. Everyone's getting cut and slashed and hit.
I still remember the last scene of that first movie. Guards right next to you, by the way. Yep, got him.
Got him.
Do you remember the last scene of that where they fade out?
The first movie?
Uh-huh.
I actually don't.
So it's the four turtles and Splinter talking. And Splinter made a joke and all the turtles were looking at each other like, he made a joke.
It's like, oh, ha, 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 I made a funny.
Yep.
Yeah, I remember that.
That's it.
Oh my god. I remember that. Yeah. Ha, 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 I made a funny.
Exactly.
Oh, I love that.
I think they were sitting up on a roof or something.
Yeah. And he just made a really stupid joke.
I don't remember the joke was. I remember that scene, though.
I don't remember the joke. I just remember Splinter saying, ha ha ha, I made a funny.
Uh-huh.
And everyone's like, what just happened?
That's how the movie ends.
Yep. That was a great Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie.
Yep. Then they screwed it up.
Shame about the recent one, though.
Yep, they Bay-ized it.
Shame. Shame. Am I going through this door?
Yes.
Okay. But seriously, shame on that movie. Ah. Oh my god.
I haven't watched it, I've just seen the trailers.
I can't bear to watch it because they have noses. Ooh, camera.
Oh, I got it. Got it. I already had it. I'm ahead of you.
Alright.
So this is the tell me when you're ready.
Hang on, I'll just find the pressure plate.
Oh, it's on the other side of the wall.
Damn it.
You were close though.
It was one or the other. The pressure plate is not working, Aaron.
You're not on top of it yet.
I can't move any further.
Okay, I'll hit it.
Thanks. Passcode.
Okay, I gotta get there. One second.
There's actually no camera here. Not on this side.
Not on that side, no.
Yeah, there's just this camera on the fourth side. Which is weird, because I think the cameras switch positions.
No, I'm pretty sure that's the same.
No.
Okay,
I was hiding against this box on the other way.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Passcode 1567.
1567? That's a different passcode. They're changing it up. I guess they're changing it up so that you can't just memorize.
Yeah.
Alright, there's going to be a camera in this room?
Yeah, you ready?
Ready.
Go. Because the other camera's gonna turn around.
Plug me in and we'll see if this decryption key is good.
Alright, plugging you in. Oh, hang on. There's intel! Oh, taking the intel. Rootkit is in.
The room's clear, so.
I know, I just like being sneaky. Also, looking at that booty. That booty has an unnatural sway to it, man.
It's all about the bass.
All about... Oh my god. All about that bass,
Very catchy.
It is. Alright, oh, I need to grab this piece of intel here.
Rotating the camera.
Got it, okay.
Hold on.
Approaching the outer doorway.
Yep.
Got it?
Go.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Okay, I just heard the ting.
Yeah.
Laser wires.
Ready? Go.
Going. I'm gone. Whoop.
And you have a camera here. So I'll wait till you get to the end. Alright, go. Alright.
Soon I will be safe on the second floor. Oh no, wait, I'm going to the first floor. My bad.
Mm-hmm. Unless you want intel. We've gotten 5 out of 10.
5 of 10. I'm good with 5 of 10.
Very good. Now you can walk out quietly.
Watcha! Oh, shit.
What? You trying to knock him out? What are you doing?
No. I tried to, like, jump over. I tried to body slam him by jumping, but I forgot the space isn't jump.
Yes, there is no jump in this game.
There is no jump in this game, so I can't just, like, body slam people. Alright, peace out.
Oh, no. You sure that was the hardest difficulty?
That was the hardest difficulty.
Okay.
Max difficulty, dude. No lie. Secondary objectives. Playstyles achieved. Ghost, MacGyver, Pacifist, and Anonymous. Which one? I forgot the last one.
Which one? Oh, the one you attempted?
The playstyles achieved. I'm missing one. There's five of them.
Oh, Assault and Battery.
Assault and Battery? The hell did I... Oh.
You knocked the one dude out in the stairwell.
Listen! Okay?
There's a 90s show.
He had it coming.
Mm-hmm.
Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's a 90s show. Oh my god. Oh! There actually was one that I was not allowed to watch.